Welcome to part two of Truth or Dare, Classical Music Edition. So I'm picking up from where I left off last time, right? We have five truths and we have five more dares in here. So let's get to it. This time I'm gonna start with a dare because I started with truth last time and my truths were quite depressing. Oh, it's the Lindsey Stirling one. All right. Let me show off my dance abilities. You know when I'm squatting, it's getting serious. I can't do it the same way. If you could pick, which composer would you pick to be the next U.S. president? I would say Florence Price. I think she seems, based on like what I've read on her biography and based on her music, I'm basing it off of her music too, I think she would serve as a good president. Violin reverse hands. Have you ever thought about quitting? When and why? There has only been one time in my life when I actually thought about quitting, not violin, but music entirely. And that time was now. Is now. Gosh, I don't know how to get into this. Basically, this is my senior year. I have been in school for 6 weeks now. And I have been made aware in very unfortunate circumstances that there is a lot of grooming and sexual abuse in the music world. And as a female, that is terrifying. And I've heard more and more stories of brutal sexual abuse situations that occur and that are shoved under the rug in the music world. And it came to a point where I was seriously considering, like, I don't want to be a part of this. If it's gonna be like this, I don't even wanna be the change. I don't wanna have anything to do with it at all. And I was genuinely feeling that way for a few weeks. And I guess I still kind of am. I'm getting through it with the help of my two incredible violin teachers that are helping me through these really dark times. And yeah, but it's common to think about quitting, some for smaller reasons and some for really big reasons like this. Happy thoughts now. Play cello with a violin bow. Okay. Play cello reverse hands. Okay. Worst stand partner experience. Oh, come on, I know it. Oh, okay. I've been in multiple youth orchestra groups, so I'm not calling anyone out. But in one particular youth orchestra group that I was in, it was my very first rehearsal there, my very first stand partner. I was so excited. And it was this boy, and he was few years younger than me, actually, because yeah, I was older. He was younger than me, quite a bit younger. And you know, we said hi to each other, we were warming up before the rehearsal started, and all of a sudden he just stops playing. And he's like clearly listening to me play, and I keep playing a little bit, and then I finally stop, and he's like, "You play really out of tune." And although it was this little boy, it was my first time there, and I was like, little, stupid, naive, young little me, and I'm just like, well, yeah, I'm still working on it. I made a couple comments, actually, during the rehearsal. And eventually just kind of like quieted down and stopped. I think he got a little bit humbled when he realized that we were not first stand, you know, we were not the best in that group. So yeah, and then I guess my other thing, I hate it when like stand partners like steal the stand and it's like totally to them and then you're here and then like you can't see the music and you try to move it and you ask to move it and they kind of move it but they don't, and then you don't want to seem like be a pain for asking them to move it like time and time again but they're not moving it, so then you just give up and they just can't see the music and then it looks like you don't know what you're doing. Happens to me all the time because I don't stand up for myself. So I don't stand up for myself. Good one. Play cello reverse hands. Okay. Like this. I would be like this. Should I play the same song I played? Hardest concerto to learn. People think I'm crazy when I say this. At least some people do. But the Mendelssohn Violin Concerto, that concerto is incredibly difficult. I don't know why like it gets this label as like a kiddie concerto. I'm like, dude. And maybe it was just like the era of my life and of like a violinist's life. At that point, when you're learning the Mendelssohn Violin Concerto and you're at that level, it's a very difficult concerto to learn. There are so many elements that go into that concerto and it is a big concerto. So, Mendelssohn. Very last truth and dares. Starting with a dare. Demonstrate triplet hemiolas. If you don't know, I am in a rhythm and intonation class, and this element of our first skills check took me forever to learn, and I finally can do it. So, I think I just included that in here because I really wanted to just show it off. So, in case you didn't know, these are triplet hemiolas. So the first one I did was quarter note triplets. I was clapping quarter note triplets. And then I was doing half note triplets, and then I did whole note triplets. You need to learn how to do them. Take music theory lessons with me. All right, last one, and it's a truth. Best moment in music. That's a perfect one to end on. Oh, I know this one. I think my best moment in music was my senior year of high school. I was accepted to Allstate, and I had been accepted to Allstate my junior year too, but I just never thought I could be in the Honors Orchestra. If you know how Allstate works, there's the Honors Orchestra, which is the top orchestra, and then there's the Allstate Orchestra, which is just the orchestra below it. And the year before I had been in the orchestra below it, I was like, oh, there's no way I'm gonna be in the Honors Ensemble. Like, oh my gosh. And I genuinely believed it though, like wholeheartedly. There was no shadow of a doubt in my head. And results came out before our first rehearsal, maybe 30 minutes before our first rehearsal. And I go to look for my name and I'm like, oh, here's my name. And I slide across, I said Honors Orchestra. I was alone when I found that out and I was like screaming and I started crying and I was like, oh my God. And I like texted my director, and my stand partner was like the sweetest girl in the whole world. I was actually on the outside of the stand in high school. I was like always on the inside of the stand for most of the stuff I was doing. So I didn't have to turn pages. We played Shostakovich. That's where I learned my love for Shostakovich was that year. And it was incredible. It was one of those moments where it's like, this is why I want to do this. And it's a moment I will keep dear to me. I hope you enjoyed this part 2 of Truth or Dare Classical Musicians Edition.